Hello everyone. In the last two videos on this chapter, we discussed about introductory part of genetics and some important terminologies that are the basis for understanding of genetics. This video mainly contains inheritance of one gene and inheritance of two genes. Along with this, back cross, test cross and principles of Mendel or laws of inheritance. Inheritance of one gene. Inheritance of one gene is explained using monohybrid cross. Monohybrid cross is a cross involving two plants differing in one character pair. It is a cross involving two plants differing in one character pair. For example, Mendel crossed pure tall and pure dwarf pea plant to study the inheritance of one gene. He crossed the homozygous tall and homozygous dwarf plant to study the inheritance of one gene. As you all know, Mendel selected garden pea plant for his experiment. He crossed the pure tall and pure dwarf pea plant as a parent. The offspring produced were all tall. That means F1 were all tall. Next, he allowed the F1 to self-pollinate. This F1 produces two different type of gamete, that is capital T and small t, in equal proportion. So he selected homozygous tall and homozygous dwarf pea plant as a parent. F1 were all tall. Next, he allow the F1 to self-pollinate. They produce two different type of gamete, that is capital T and small t, in equal proportion. During the fertilization, the pollen grain of capital T have the 50% chance to pollinate eggs of capital T and small t. Similarly, the pollen grains of small t have 50% chance to pollinate eggs of capital T and small t. Therefore, 1/4 of random fertilization lead to capital T, half of random fertilization lead to capital T, small t, and 1/4 of random fertilization lead to small t, small t. So, during fertilization, the pollen grain of capital T have the 50% chance to pollinate eggs of capital T and small t. Similarly, pollen grains of small t have 50% chance to pollinate eggs of capital T and small t. Therefore, random fertilization lead to 1/4 of capital T, half of capital T, small t, and 1/4 of small t, small t. Next, applying binomial expression AX plus BY the whole square for this F1 selfing, that means capital T small t into capital T small t. Hence, we get the ratio 1:2:1. This is the genotypic ratio. The second filial generation, that means F2 generation, both tall and dwarf plants appeared in the ratio 3:1. Respectively, that means 3 tall and 1 dwarf plant. This ratio is called as phenotypic ratio. Phenotype, the physical expression of a character. Out of every 4 plants of F2 generation, 1 is homozygous tall, that is capital T, 2 were heterozygous tall, that is capital T, small t, and 1 is homozygous tall, that is small t, small t. Therefore, the ratio is 1:2:1. This is called as genotypic ratio. What is the monohybrid phenotypic ratio? Monohybrid phenotypic ratio is 3:1. 3 tall, 1 dwarf. What is the genotypic ratio of monohybrid cross? 1:2:1. T, 1. T, 2, and t, 1. 1:2:1. So here the schematic representation that express the monohybrid cross. कैपिटल टी कैपिटल टी दैट मीन्स होमोजाइगस स्टॉल प्लांट क्रॉस्ड विथ होमोजाइगस डॉट प्लांट. होमोजाइगस स्टॉल प्लांट प्रोड्यूसेस गैमेट कैपिटल टी, होमोजाइगस स्टॉल प्लांट प्रोड्यूसेस गैमेट स्मॉल टी. F1 वॉज हेट्रोजाइगस स्टॉल वेन दे सेल्फ्ड. देन गैमेट्स टू टाइप गैमेट दे प्रोड्यूसेस कैपिटल टी एंड स्मॉल टी इन इक्वल प्रोपोर्शन. इन F2 जनरेशन द फिनोटाइपिक रेशियो इज 3:1 एंड जीनोटाइपिक रेशियो इज 1:2:1. टू एक्सप्लेन वन जीन इनहेरिटेंस मेंडल सेलेक्टेड होमोजाइगस स्टॉल एंड होमोजाइगस डॉर्फ पी प्लांट एज अ पेरेंट. दिस एक्स साइन और इंटू साइन इंडिकेट क्रॉस बिटवीन दिस टू प्लांट, क्रॉस बिटवीन दिस टू प्लांट. सो दिस आर द पेरेंट्स. होमोजाइगस स्टॉल प्लांट प्रोड्यूसेस ओनली वन काइंड ऑफ गैमेट, दैट गैमेट विथ कैपिटल टी. सिमिलरली होमोजाइगस डॉर्फ पी प्लांट प्रोड्यूसेस वन काइंड ऑफ गैमेट, दैट गैमेट विथ स्मॉल टी. आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन और सिंगैमी न्यू जनरेशन इज फॉर्म्ड, दैट इज F1 जनरेशन. दिस इज F1 हाइब्रिड. F1 हाइब्रिड वेर ऑल टॉल. F1 हाइब्रिड वेर ऑल टॉल. नेक्स्ट इज सेल्फ्ड F1. नेक्स्ट इज सेल्फ्ड F1. दिस F1 प्रोड्यूसेस टू टाइप ऑफ गैमेट, दैट इज गैमेट विथ कैपिटल टी एंड गैमेट विथ स्मॉल टी इन इक्वल प्रोपोर्शन. सेम थिंग हियर, गैमेट विथ कैपिटल टी, गैमेट विथ स्मॉल टी. दिस फर्स्ट प्लांट कंसिडर इट इज अ फीमेल प्लांट एंड दिस इज अ मेल पेरेंट. दिस इज फीमेल पेरेंट, दिस इज मेल पेरेंट. ओके, दिस आर द एग सेल. दिस इज मेल गैमेट्स. मेल गैमेट प्रेजेंट इन पोलन ग्रेन्स. सो नाउ कंसिडर द पोलन ग्रेन ऑफ, पोलन ग्रेन ऑफ कैपिटल टी हैज़ द 50% चांस टू पॉलिनेट एग ऑफ कैपिटल टी और स्मॉल टी. पोलन ग्रेन ऑफ कैपिटल टी हैज 50% चांस टू पॉलिनेट एग ऑफ कैपिटल टी और एग ऑफ स्मॉल टी. सेम थिंग हियर, द पोलन ग्रेन ऑफ स्मॉल टी हैज 50% चांस टू पॉलिनेट एग ऑफ कैपिटल टी एंड एग ऑफ स्मॉल टी. Now F2 generation are capital T, capital T, capital T, small t. Okay, capital T, small t, small t, small t. So F1, first one, it is a homozygous tall. This is also tall. This is also tall. These two are heterozygous tall. This is homozygous tall. This is dwarf plant. Now phenotypic ratio 3 tall, 1 dwarf. Means phenotypic ratio is 3:1. Genotype capital T, capital T, 1. Capital T, small t, 2, and small t, 1. That means genotypic ratio 1:2:1. This is the phenotypic ratio. This is genotypic ratio of Mendel monohybrid cross or one gene inheritance. Mendel applied binomial expression for selfing of F1 hybrid. For this cross, he applied the binomial expression, that is AX plus BY the whole square, to this cross. By simplifying this cross or binomial expression to this cross, we get 1/2 capital T plus 1/2 small t into 1/2 capital T plus 1/2 small t. So this is multiplied with this. We get 1/4 capital T capital T plus, this is multiplied with this, 1/4 capital T small t plus, this is multiplied with this, 1/4 capital T small t plus this with this 1 by 4 small t small t. Again simplifying, we get 1 by 2 capital T small t plus 1 by 4 small t small t. By this, he derived the genotypic ratio, that is 1 is to 2 is to 1. This is the monohybrid genotypic ratio, 1 is to 2 is to 1. Here, this is homozygous tall, this is heterozygous tall. Tall, this is homozygous dwarf. That indicates the phenotypic ratio is 3 is to 1. 3 tall, 1 dwarf. So, this is the expression for Mendel's monohybrid cross. Based on this, next is back cross. Back cross is a crossing of F1 hybrid with any one of its parent. Crossing of F1 hybrid with any one of its parent. Suppose F1 hybrid is crossed with the dominant parent, then it is called as dominant back crossed. F1 hybrid crossed with the dominant parent, then it is called as dominant back crossed. The diagram A represents dominant back crossed. When F1 hybrid is crossed with recessive parent, F1 hybrid is crossed with recessive parent, then it is called as recessive back cross or test cross. Recessive back cross or test cross. Why it is test cross? Because it is used to identify genotype of unknown individual. Okay, here diagram B represents the test cross or back cross. So what is test cross? Crossing of F1 hybrid with its recessive parent. Crossing of F1 hybrid with its recessive parent. So F1 plant obtained by crossing of pure tall and pure dwarf plant. Okay, F1 plant obtained by the crossing of pure tall and pure dwarf P plant. Okay, and F1 were all tall. In the test cross of Mendel, he cross-pollinated F1 with the fully recessive parent, that is small t small t. In test cross, Mendel cross-pollinated F1 with the fully recessive parent, that is small t small t. The offsprings were both tall and dwarf plant in a ratio 1 is to 1. Both tall and dwarf plant appeared in a ratio 1 is to 1. This is ratio is called as monohybrid test cross ratio. This experiment confirms that F1 plant were heterozygous tall. F1 were heterozygous in condition. Okay, therefore, what is the monohybrid test cross ratio? It is 1 is to 1. In this diagram, you can observe the capital T small t in a hybrid, the gamete produced. In recessive plant, only one type of gamete, that is small t. So, using checkerboard, he calculated the all possible genotype of F2 generation, in which he got 50% tall and 50% dwarf plant. As a result, the monohybrid test cross ratio was 1 is to 1. Remember, suppose dihybrid test cross ratio, they asked, then write 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. You try to calculate the dihybrid test cross ratio after studying dihybrid cross. Next, what is the significance of this test cross? It is the most important question. What is the significance of this test cross? Test cross is used to find out the unknown genotype of a character. It is used to find out the unknown genotype of a character. Mendel conducted test cross to determine the F2 generation. For determination of F2 generation, Mendel performed the test cross, and it also helpful in identifying the unknown genotype of a character. Okay. Test cross is a cross between F1 hybrid with its recessive parent to identify the unknown genotype of F1 hybrid. By the test cross, we also identify the F2 generation. In Mendel monohybrid cross, F1 were all tall. That means there may be two possibilities. One is it may be pure tall, that is homozygous tall, or it may be heterozygous tall. It may be pure tall or it may be heterozygous tall. Okay, first consider the hybrids were homozygous tall. Then what happened? F1 is crossed with its recessive parent. This produces gamete capital T. This produces gamete small t. That na F2 generation all were tall. Okay, when F1 hybrid is homozygous tall. Now consider F1 hybrid were heterozygous tall. Then what happened? When F1 hybrid is crossed with its recessive parent, this F1 hybrid produces two kinds of gamete, capital T and small t, and this parent produces gamete all with small t. In F2 generation, we get tall and dwarf plant, both tall and dwarf plant in equal proportion. So these two cross identifies or explain the F1 was heterozygous tall, not homozygous tall. So test cross is useful for the identification of F1 hybrid genotype, unknown genotype of F1 hybrid. How it is possible? Because in Mendel crossed, in F2 generation he got both tall and dwarf plant. Suppose it is homozygous tall, then only tall plants are produced, but not possible. They produced both tall and dwarf plant in a 3:1 ratio, phenotypic ratio. Okay, by this test cross, we identify unknown genotype of the F1 hybrid, also the F2 generation. That means F2 generation we get tall and dwarf plant. Next, Mendel's principle or laws of inheritance. The first law is law of dominance. Law of dominance states that the characters are controlled by discrete unit called factors. Factors occur in a pair. In a dissimilar pair of factor, one member is dominant and other one is recessive. Characters are controlled by discrete unit called factor. Factors are present in pair. In dissimilar pair, one member is dominant, other is recessive. As we all know, these factors are nothing but genes. So character is controlled by genes. Genes are appear in pairs. The alternative form of a gene we call them as alleles. Okay. In dissimilar pair means in heterozygous condition, one is dominant, another one is recessive. Second law, law of segregation. It is also called as law of purity of gamete. Law of segregation or law of purity of gamete. In which during gamete formation, the factors or alleles of a character pair present in a parent. During gamete formation, the factors or alleles of a character pair present in parents segregate from one another. Segregate from one another such that gamete receives only one of two factors. Gamete receives only one of two factors. What it states, during gamete formation, the factors or alleles of a character pair separate from one another such that gamete receives any one of two factors. Okay, in homozygous parent produces only one type of gamete. In heterozygous parent produces two kinds of gamete having one allele with equal proportion. Remember, the first and second law of Mendel was purely based on monohybrid cross. Suppose they asked, explain the law of segregation for 5 marks. Then you write the definition first or statement first, then explain the monohybrid cross. Suppose they asked, explain the law of segregation with schematic representation. Then first write the statement of law of segregation, then write the schematic representation of monohybrid cross. Okay, this is for first and second law of Mendel, which is purely based on monohybrid cross. Another law is present, third law, that is law of independent assortment, but it is not on basis of one gene inheritance. It's based on the dihybrid cross. So I will explain that in that time only. Based on the one gene inheritance or monohybrid cross, Mendel proposed two laws. One is law of dominance, another one is law of segregation. According to law of dominance, the characters are controlled by discrete unit called factors. Factors are nothing but genes. So here tall, the tall character is controlled by a discrete unit, that is gene capital T, and dwarf is controlled by the gene small t. Okay. Secondly, these factors are present in pairs. Here see, capital T, small t, they are present in pairs. Okay. Suppose dissimilar pair, one is dominant, other one is recessive. Means only one expressed its character, other suppresses its character. Here, capital T expresses its character, so plant becomes tall. And small t suppresses its character. This is the law of dominance. Second law is law of segregation or purity of gamete. Here, during gamete formation, these two factors or alleles of a character pair present in a parent segregate from one another. Here they segregate or separated from one another such that gamete receives only one of two factors. Homozygous condition, gamete consists of only one kind of alleles or factor. In heterozygous condition, there are two types of gamete are formed, or two kinds of gamete are formed. So in homozygous, only one kind of gamete. In heterozygous, two type of gametes are formed. What is law of segregation? Law of segregation state that during gamete formation, the factors or alleles of a character pair, alleles of a character pair present in parent segregate from one another, separate from one another, such that gamete receives any one of two factors. Next is inheritance of two genes. Inheritance of two genes is explained using dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross is a cross between two plants differing in two pairs of contrasting character. Monohybrid cross means cross between two plants differing one pair of contrasting character. Here, two pair of contrasting character. Suppose trihybrid cross then differ in three pair of contrasting character. Okay, then what is dihybrid cross? It is a cross between two plants or two parents differ in two pairs of contrasting character. For example, the cross between pea plant with round shape and yellow colored seed and wrinkle shape and green color seed. Cross between round shape and yellow color seed and wrinkle shape and green color seed pea plant. Capital R represent round shape, capital Y represent yellow color, small r represent wrinkle shape, and small y represent green color. Remember, Mendel in his dihybrid experiment crossed pure round yellow plant with wrinkle green seeded plant. as a parent. Okay, F1 were all round yellow seeded. F1 were all round yellow seeded. This shows the yellow is dominant over green and round is dominant over wrinkle. Yellow is dominant over green and round is dominant over wrinkle. That means the capital Y is dominant over small y and capital R is dominant over small r. Okay, next he allow the F1 to self-pollinate. He allow the F1 to self-pollinate. On observing F2, Mendel found that yellow and green color segregate in a ratio 3:1. Similarly, round and wrinkle segregate in a ratio 3:1. So, dihybrid phenotypic ratio was 9:3:3:1. 9 round yellow, 3 round green, 3 wrinkled yellow and 1 wrinkled green. This is obtained by combination series. This can be obtained by combination series. Okay, 3 yellow, 1 green with 3 round and 1 wrinkle. Because he observed that yellow and green color segregate in a ratio 3:1. Round and wrinkle segregate in a ratio 3:1. So he applied combination series. He found that the phenotypic ratio was 9:3:3:1. Where 9 were round yellow, 3 were round green, 3 were wrinkled yellow and 1 is wrinkled green. And the genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:4. 1:2:2:1:2:1. 1:2:2:4. 1:2:1:2:1. Here also the combination series will apply for the genotypic ratio, that is 1:2:1 and 1:2:1. That means yellow and green segregated in 1:2:1 ratio, genotypic ratio, and 3:1 is segregated in 1:2:1 genotypic ratio. In F2, he obtained 9 different types of genotypes. They were capital R, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R, small y, small y, capital R, small y, small y, small r, small r, capital Y, capital Y, small r, capital Y, small y, small r, small y, small y, in a ratio 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1. This is the schematic representation for dihybrid crossed. To explain 2-gene inheritance or dihybrid cross, Mendel selected pure round-shaped yellow color seeded plant and wrinkle-shaped green color seeded plant as a parent. He crossed capital R, capital Y with small r, small y. Okay, this capital R is dominant over small r. Capital Y is dominant over small y. That means round is dominant over wrinkled, yellow is dominant over green. Okay, so this plant produces gamete with capital R, capital Y. This plant produces gamete with small y, small r. Why two alleles are present here? Because it is a dihybrid crossed gamete consisting alleles of these two characters. Okay. Next, F1 generation were all round yellow. F1 generation were all round yellow. Next, selfing of F1 hybrids. This F1 produces four kinds of gamete. Which are they? Capital R, capital Y, gamete with capital R, capital Y, gamete with capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. So here, which are the gamete? Capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. So, four kind of gametes are produced. This is for F1 generation and their gametes. Next, F2 generation. These are the gametes from female parents. These are the gametes from male parent. So, 16 different individuals are formed. Okay, see here, capital R, capital Y is present. Dominant factor is present. Therefore, this is nothing but round LO. The phenotype is round LO. Here also, capital R is present, capital Y is present. So, again it is round LO. Here, capital R, capital Y is present, round LO. This is also round LO. Here also round LO. Here round is present, but capital Y is absent. Both are recessive alleles. Therefore, the character is green, round green. Round LO. Round, but not LO. Here it is green. Round LO. Round LO. Here, round character is not expressed. Why? Capital R is not present. Both are recessive. Therefore, here, wrinkled LO. Wrinkled LO. Round LO. Round, but green. Wrinkled LO. Wrinkled, but green. Because both are recessive. These are the different phenotypes. Okay, now find out the phenotypic and genotypic ratio to this cross, dihybrid cross. See here, one round LO. So first, how many different types of phenotypes are obtained here? Round LO, round green, wrinkled LO, wrinkled green. Round LO, round green, wrinkled LO, wrinkled green. Means four different types of phenotypes obtained. Which are they? Round LO, round green, wrinkled LO, and wrinkled green. How many round LO is present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. 9 round LO. Round green. 1, 2 and 3. 3 round green. Wrinkled LO. 1, 2, 3. And wrinkled green, only one. So, for your remembrance, see properly. This is round LO. This is round LO. Round LO. Round LO. Round LO. Round LO. So, in this triangle, all are round LO. In this triangle, all are round LO. Okay. Next, round green. In this L shape, one skip, one skip, one. These three are round green. One skip, one. This L shape are round green. Okay. Next, see here. These three are wrinkled LO. They are in L shape or 90 degree. And finally, this is the wrinkled green. So, 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. This is the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. Phenotypic ratio. 9 round LO, 3 round green, 3 wrinkled LO and 1 wrinkled green. This is the phenotypic ratio. Next, the genotypic ratio. See, first we write different genotype, that is capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. 1. Next, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. 1. Capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. 1. Capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. 1. Okay. Next, capital R, capital Y. It is repeated, so I will write here plus 1. Next, capital R, small y, 1. Next, capital Y, small y. It is also again repeated, so I will write plus 1 here. Capital R, small y, small y. Capital R, small y, small y. 1. Next, R, capital Y. Same thing repeated here, so plus 1. R, capital Y, small y. Here plus 1. Small r, capital Y, 1. Small r, capital Y, 1. It is also repeated, so I will write here. R, small y. It is also repeated. Where it is? R, small y. Here plus 1. Next, r, capital Y, small y. It is also repeated, plus 1. Next, r, small y, 1. So, what is the ratio? 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. This is the genotypic ratio of Mendel's dihybrid cross. 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. Total 16. See here, to your remembrance, okay, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 is 2, 4, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 is 2, 4, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1. Understood? 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 is 2, 4 is 2, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1. This is the genotypic ratio. 1 is 2, 2 is 2. These two are same. These two are same. These four are same. 1, these two are same. This 1, these two are same. And this is 1. So 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 is 2. 4 is 2, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 1. This is the genotypic ratio of Mendel's law. Okay, clear? To obtain the genotypic and phenotypic ratio in dihybrid crossed, Mendel applied the combination series. Here, this round and wrinkled, segregate in a ratio 3:1. In F2 generation, 3:1 phenotypic ratio, and genotypic ratio is 1:1:1. Okay. Similarly, this yellow and green segregate in a ratio 3:1, that is 1:2:1. Clear? So he applied combination series for this. 3:1 × 3:1. He get 9:3:3:1. That is the phenotypic ratio. Applying combination series for genotypic ratio, then what we get? 1:2:2:2:4:1:2:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2:1:2: 1:2:1. This is the genotypic ratio. Okay, this is the phenotypic and genotypic ratio he obtained using combination series for round and wrinkle and yellow and green. So next is Mendel's third law or law of independent assortment. As only I first told, it is mainly based on the dihybrid cross. So it states that when a cross involving two or more than two character pairs, the factor pair independently segregate from one pair of a character. So it states that when more than one pair of a character present in a cross, the factor pair independently segregate from one pair of character. So based on the result of this dihybrid cross or two gene inheritance, Mendel proposed another law, that is third law of Mendel, law of independent assortment. According to this law, a cross containing more than one character pair, this character pair segregate independently. Here round and wrinkle segregate independently from yellow and green. Okay, round and wrinkle segregate in a ratio 3:1. Similarly, yellow and green is segregate in a ratio 3:1. They are independent of each other. Here round may fused with carry the yellow color or green color. It is independent of this color. Shape is independent of color. This explains the law of independent assortment. This is the end of the slide. So thank you everyone for your attention.